Now, I'm sure the following video is going to ruffle some feathers, and all I ask is that you watch it till the end to see what I hope is a deeper truth. So the title of this video, Why You Must Talk About Donald Trump on a First Date. Now, here's the thing. Most dating professionals or anyone else will tell you that talking about politics and religion on a first date is taboo. And if we kind of look at the deeper reason why they might suggest that is because oftentimes these can be very combative subjects, okay? And it's not just politics or religion, it could be a variety of different subjects. Is stay away from the tough stuff because that might create friction, that may create controversy. And I'm here to say hogwash. It's the exact opposite of what you might want to consider. And so this video isn't about politics per se. I'm only using Donald Trump because it happens to be the president at this time. And on a lot of dating sites or dating apps, you will see things that say, if you voted for Trump, swipe the other way, or I voted for Trump, so swipe this way. And I'm just suggesting this, but it's not about your politics here. What the deeper truth I want to get into is this idea of combative subjects, because most people will suggest that your first few dates should be light and fluffy and carefree and just about having fun. And this is great. It's fantastic just to have fun, right? But let me tell you what oftentimes happens. If you have even a little bit of chemistry, you're just approaching the process of having fun, you know, and just, you know, just having a good time, and maybe you start kissing one another, you start becoming more amorous with one another, you start to have more intimacy with one another, you begin to have sex with one another, only to find out 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 weeks down the road that the two of you aren't compatible. And boy, is that an emotional letdown to find out that somebody you've spent time investing your heart in and your physical body only to find out that they're not compatible with you. So here's where I want to kind of go off, you know, bring it back to the idea of talking about politics and or religion or whatever those might be tough subjects, is that if it turns out to be a combative conversation with someone, in other words, you don't share the same politics, you don't share the same religion, what you're looking for at this particular moment is an open-minded person versus a closed-minded person. Let me repeat that. What you're looking for is an open-minded person versus a closed-minded person, because someone who's closed-minded when it comes to discussing politics, religion, money, sex, all these different things, can be a challenging relationship in the long run. And if you're not familiar with Dr. John Gottman, I highly recommend you check out his book, 8 Dates. 8 Dates by Dr. John Gottman, who's a renowned therapist, couples therapist, who's studied what it takes to create a successful relationship. And why I'm suggesting this book is because conflict resolution is one of the fundamental keys to a successful relationship. And so imagine this, you know, I mean, you've spent time becoming connected with another person, you have chemistry, you've built up this familiarity, only to find out the two of you can't handle conflict very well. In fact, conflict resolution is the primary reason why so many relationships don't go the distance. And so talking about politics, talking about religion, talking about the tough stuff, you actually get to witness how someone operates when they're potentially, I'm not saying this is an absolute, but potentially how they navigate difficult conversations. And that's what I'm really talking about. And so those difficult conversations might reflect politics, religion, money, about paying for dates and that sort of thing, sex, child rearing. I mean, there's the list can go on and on of the challenging subjects. And I'm not suggesting that first dates is all a downer and it's all a interrogation or whatnot. But the reality is this, when you invest time with another human being, you become attached to that other person. So I caution those who get attached quickly to maybe take a step back and really, really vet the person that you might start dating. Because that's what dating is. It's a vetting process to see, well, I mean, it can be. I'm not everyone wants to be in a long-term serious relationship. But for those of you that are like me, I want to get remarried. I'm very crystal clear. I want a serious, committed, long-term relationship and or marriage. I'm very succinct in stating that clearly. And so if you're the same, if you're like me, I would certainly interject that early in the conversation and even approach the process as a vetting process. The dating process is to vet if they're a really good candidate to be that person you might want to marry or be in relationship with. Now, I know most of you will be told, just be casual, don't put any pressure. But that's the problem with today. It's so casual, there's no pressure that you're finding out you're investing time with an incompatible person. And let me tell you something, that wears on someone's emotions, that wears on someone's heart. And so my invitation for you is to go a little bit deeper and ask those tougher questions. And just, again, this video is about really looking at the difference between an open-minded person and a closed-minded person. And so ask some of those tougher questions just to see how they respond. And if it becomes combative, chances are you aren't going to be a good fit anyway. And I know a lot of you are in the camp, well, if you just love each other, you can solve everything, which is a fucking crock of shit, because that doesn't seem to work. Because if people loved each other, everyone would stay married and everyone would be happy. Love is not the glue that keeps people together. John Gottman talks about the 8 things that are most important in keeping a relationship together, and conflict resolution is one of those. And that's why you must talk about Donald Trump on a first date. Hey, I hope you found value in this video. I'd like to hear your thoughts. Please post a comment below if you think this is just full of shit or if there's some value here. I want to hear about it. Let's get a discussion going. If you find value in this video, I want to invite you to go to my website, jonathanasley.com. Click the group coaching button. It takes you to one of my programs called Midlife Love Mastery. And this is a program where I shoot videos on a daily basis for the group. We have a once a month Q&A call, and it costs $1 to join, and it's less than a half a cup of coffee a day to be a member. So it's great value. So check it out, jonathanasley.com. Click the group coaching button, Midlife Love Mastery. Okay, I'm going to sign off on this video, as I always do, giving you a big, gigantic Jonathan Bear hug, if I have your consent. Aw, thank you. Wishing you a wonderful day. Thanks so much. Bye-bye now.